Henry Fu, Occupational Hazards. Occupational Hazards, Henry Fu.
Fellow Toastmasters, guests, honorable judges, and my worthy opponents. Have you ever invested in the stock market, unit trust, properties, gold? Anyone?
Yes.
Yes, if some of you raise your hands. How about life insurance products? Do you all believe in life insurance? Have you ever bought a policy in life insurance? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah. Hey, any agent here? Market man here. I'm sharing with you. So, selling life insurance is a very challenging job. I want to read an anecdote about a life insurance agent who sells very innovatively and creatively. The husband of a pregnant woman is considering to buy a policy for an unborn child. So he approached Great Eastern. And the agent says, we have a policy that will protect your unborn child from the basket to the casket. Or from the cradle to the crematorium. The man was impressed. He thought he should seek another opinion. So he approached Prudential. And the Prudential agent said to this guy, don't worry, we have a policy that protects the insured from the womb to the tomb. This man, we thought that all these insurance salesmen might be talk bullshit. So he approached AIA and told AIA agent what Prudential and Great Eastern had offered. Okay, we very clear. About it. They come to the person telling about this. We have another policy that covers you from erection to resurrection. Imagine such a policy. Incidentally, there is a policy from Prudential. It's called a Prove My Child Enhancement. And this policy covers unborn baby from the fetus of the mother to age 2 years. So now you want to buy a policy for unborn child, you can have it. From 18 weeks to 35 weeks gestation period, you can buy a policy. Is there something new to you? Pregnant mothers around here? Or anybody baby in making? Think about this one. Now talking about erection. One of our PM, ex-PMs, in those days, when the country's economy is bad and people are complaining, you're saying in Bahasa Malaysia, harga barang naik, harga minyak naik, harga gula naik juga. The situation was bad. And this ex-PM, after the first wife passed away, he remarried. And the opposition politicians took advantage of the situation. He married because itu pun naik. You know, he said in jest that this ex-PM married because that thing also naik. So, not a good thing, I suppose. And then there's another one, bring to this one. There was a man, an elderly man. Looks like, talks like, behaves like GJM. But it's not GJM. It was a very complexion. On the way, on those days, he was passing by a bottle. And prostitute halal customers approached this man. Come lah, try lah. You never know, see? But the man says, this is a senior citizen. I cannot la, da bole. See, the prostitute was persistent and tried to sweet talk to the guy. You belum cuba, mana tahu. So she says, try. You don't know until you try it. So the citizen couldn't resist the offer, and that woman was already voluptuous. So he had to go. And after the performance, the prostitute was surprised. You did a marvelous performance. I'm so amazed that you can perform. You performed like a below a 30-year-old guy. Maybe like a big child, or something like that. And but this guy told this prostitute, I told you I cannot just now. I told you already. What do you mean? When I said I cannot, I meant I cannot pay. So, the moral story is, when a guy says cannot to you, you better make sure you ask for clarification. Be more specific what you mean by cannot. This is Malaysia, this is Bole land. Agreed? And Bole land, we know the recent murders of Authentica Charibu. The two murders can be acquitted from the court of appeal. That's why they give Malaysia another nickname, the land of endless possibilities. And you must hire expert in law to put this two back into the pre-trial. So you hire a consultant. And what they say about consultant? They con and insult you. And after they pay for hefty fees for all those insults, okay, you get a citizen. A consultant all like that, conning people and insulting people? I don't think so. So the moral of the story here is this. Every occupation has hazards. Be careful of what career you choose or the business you're in. If the hazards, tackle them wisely and positively, and you can ensure your success. Thank you. Back to you.